Hey everyone, welcome to African Esquire TV. I'm your host, Tierney Cherie. So I seen this story about a British family who's being asked to give reparations, and I thought it was a good story to cover for a lot of reasons. So let's just jump into the story. A British millionaire's family who was involved in a slave trade is being asked to pay reparations. So anytime you see asked to pay reparations, that's not a good sign, because if reparations are something you don't ask for, it's something that's demanded. So already we should probably know that this is not going to be all that we would hope. But let's go forward. So it's estimated that about 5 million people were enslaved, and Africans who were shipped off to the Caribbean during the transatlantic slave trade. For the enslaved Africans who were able to endure the long and treacherous journey, they were forced to work on vast plantations in dangerous conditions, while their enslavers benefited from their toils. The Drax family from Britain was one of the benefactors, and people were calling them to atone for their slavery history by paying reparations. They're located in Barbados and built somewhere around 1650. The 621-acre Drax Hall, a still-functioning sugar plantation, is referred to as the killing field for alleged atrocities committed against enslaved Africans who worked there. Thousands of enslaved Africans reportedly died on the plantation. And the Drax Hall for 200 years also had up to 327 enslaved people working there. It says that Black life mattered only to make millionaires of English enslavers, and the Drax family did it longer than any other elite family. Drax Hall was one of the oldest residential properties in the Western Hemisphere and cultivated the first sugarcane in Barbados. Drax is estimated to be worth $200,850,000 and inherited the plantation from his deceased father, continues to profit from the family business. Workers on the farm are reportedly paid as low as $32 a day. I just did a video. I talked about the fact that the system still exists. This is a perfect example, because we knew that this slave plantation originally was able to exist because of slave labor. And that was how they were able to function and make millions and millions for this family. Well, when slavery ended, they didn't just get rid of exploitative labor. They found low paying labor. Sure, it had to take more out of their pocket than doing it for free, but it still allows them to maintain the same privilege and the same benefactory of being inside of a superior position of those who they are making work their lands. So it says the average wage in the Caribbean is double that. Okay. Now, Drax, who's now a member in Parliament.
Richard Drax.
Speaker, my sympathy extends to all those who are going to lose their jobs. Can I remind the Secretary of State that we are leaving the EU, and we must be able to strike our own trade deals around the world if we are to flourish as a country, and I believe we would.
To the Sunday Mirror after he was elected in 2010. Drax, who's now in Parliament, distanced himself from his family's past. "I can't be held responsible for something that happened 300 or 400 years ago," he says. "They're using the class thing, and that's not what this election is about. It's not what I stand for, and I ignore it." Yes, you can be held responsible. First of all, the sheer fact that you're in Parliament means that you're someone who's in a privileged position, and that position has been created because of the riches of your family, which come from the exploitation of African people. So yes, you can be held responsible for that, because you wouldn't even be able to run for Parliament had you not had that benefit of having that passed. Sir Hillary now disagrees, and he says it's prudent for the minister to atone for his wealthy family's past. According to him, the Drax family's involvement in the trade resulted in some 30,000 enslaved people dying in Jamaica and Barbados. "When I drive through Drax Hall, I feel a sense of being in a massive killing field with unmarked cemeteries. Sugar and Black Death went hand in hand." It's no answer for Richard Drax to say it has nothing to do with him when he is the owner and inheritor. He still owns this land. They should pay reparations. British Ambassador to CARICOM, David Comisiong, also said that this was a crime against humanity, and we impose upon him and his family a moral responsibility to contribute to efforts to repair the damage. You can't simply walk away from the scene of the crime. They have a responsibility to make some effort to repair the damage. So the millionaire Minister of Parliament, however, has told the news that I reject that assertion. I failed to declare any Barbados property holdings once owned by my father, as these are going through probate process and have not yet been transferred to my name, he says. He said, once the process is completed, I will, of course, register it in a proper accordance with the rules. I am keenly aware of the slave trade and my role in the very distant ancestor played, and it is deeply, deeply regrettable. But no one today can be held responsible for what happened many hundreds of years ago. This is a part of the nation's history. So this obviously is very indicative of how the colonizers work. And as we said, number one, he's being asked to pay reparations. That's not something that you ask. That's something that you demand. And so what they should be doing is demanding, having some type of lawsuit and going after him. If you think he's going to do it out of his good grace to give up his position of power, that's just stupid to think that that's how it's going to happen. He would have to be a good person for that to work. And this man still owns the same plantation where tens of thousands of Africans were murdered. Clearly, you're not a good person, because a good person wouldn't even want any association to that. However, I do think that we have to, number one, not just be so preoccupied with reparations, but be preoccupied with the current exploitation system, because reparations talks about the past. But before you can even atone for the past, how do you atone for the past while the present is continually exploitative? As they said, people are still being paid low wages on the same plantation where their ancestors were enslaved, still being paid low wages. So what does it do to give money for the past when they're still continuing the same thing, but in a modern context? Don't think that those $32 a day is going to mean that these people are being given something that is worth what the labor that they're actually putting in. So I say this to say, in many instances, we're talking about reparations. To me, the first step before we even talk about reparations has to be stop doing what you're doing now. Stop the colonialism, stop the neocolonialism, stop the exploitative labor, stop it now. And until you're able to stop them with what they're doing, you really can't even do anything to effectuate the past. So the clearer we become on that reality, the clearer we'll be able to really face this giant, because understand that reparations that are going to truly be something to repair the people is only going to hurt the position of the enslaver. And if the enslaver is being asked to hurt himself, you should honestly understand that that person is not going to go forward. So that's all I have on this story. What are your guys' thoughts? And I will see you in the next video.